I'm Drew Taylor with HRS Control. We're in our booth here at InfoComm 2012, and we're showing off our UDC software, which is a Windows application for configuring your control system. There's no code necessary. We have quick and easy features to build a control system all through the user interface. So one of the main things we're showing off here is our new iOS app that we have running on this iPad. The iPad is connected to a computer running our configuration for control in the booth. So I can do things like go to my video page, and you can see how quickly things navigate since this is a native iOS app, and we have all of the data cached on the device. So I could turn these lights on and off. And the response time is very quick in our app. I could go to a list, and we have an Abacus Mira list here that we query the Mira for all of the clips on the video server. So I can scroll through and select a clip, load it, play it, maybe select another clip, load it on a different channel, play, that kind of stuff. We have a Lightware controller with lists that work with our matrix router function, so I can select an output, query, change the input. We have sliders, we have all kinds of new features that we're showing at our booth here at InfoComm 2012. And I'm gonna give you a brief demo of how to start a configuration and how easy it is to configure the UDC control system. So you can watch on the screen behind me, and I'll work on this computer. So the first thing we'll do, we'll go in and we'll add a device. And I have a spider in the booth, so I'll start with that device. So we'll name the device, and we need to apply a command set so we know how to control the spider. So I'll select this spider command set that I found. Type in the IP address, save. Okay, we have our device. Now I can ping it, I have communication, that's good. And for the spider, we support the ability to query this device. So that's what I'm doing now. And you can see we've gotten all the data from the spider that we need, like the command keys, function keys, treatment sources. So this makes configuring in the software a lot easier. I'll show you a couple cool ways that we're gonna use this data that we just got from the spider. So the next thing we'll do is go in and add a custom controller. And I can define the resolution for whatever kind of tablet controller I might be using. So when I add a new controller, I get a blank slate. I can right click to do things like add button, toggle switch, list, that kind of stuff. So I'll start by adding a background image. Find an image here. So we have a background image. I'll right click, add a few buttons, and I'll click this little moving truck. So now I can click these buttons and move them around, position them where I want. And in the properties, I can add images to these buttons to customize the software however I want. So now let's make these buttons do things. I'll add a command, select the device that I just defined. We see this spider. And I see all the commands that the spider supports because we're using the spider command set here. So I'll find the common one that we use with spider is recall script queue. It's like recalling a preset. So when I select this command, one of the arguments is which preset do you want to recall? So here's that data that we had queried the spider for, the list of the command keys on the spider. So I'll just select which one I want this button to do and define which script queue, another parameter. Other commands for other devices might have other types of parameters. I could add a second command to this button if I wanted to, for the spider or a different device if I had another device to find. So let's look at another way we could use that data from the spider. So I could right click and add a list. And I'll resize it a little bit here. And I can customize the color and the name of the list and that kind of stuff. So in a list object, I could add a custom list if I wanted to, and add multiple list items and rename them, whatever I wanted to. But for here, we're going to use this device list. We're going to use that data that we queried the spider for and select command keys. So you see, it builds a list for me automatically based on the data that we've already received from the spider. So now I can easily set this up to select one of my command keys and have a go button. The entire configuration is saved as a single backup file. So if I wanted to go back to the file that we were using here in the booth for demos, I can do that, select my backup file, and the software will restart with the configuration that we had just previous to this demo running in the booth. And there we go. So the software is running. And another part of our demo would be showing our software running with our new HRS Control Pro for Windows client application, which we can run right on top of our software. So I'll click connect. We're building the controllers. And behind me now you see the home screen for our configuration that we're demoing control for different devices in the booth. And thanks for stopping by our booth at InfoComm 2012. You can learn more at our website, hrscontrol.com.